I'm going to show you how easy it is to generate an entire online course with AI. Start by going to coursebox.ai and registering for free. Next, we start by choosing our language. Choose from over 100 different languages. Describe your course. Today, I'm creating a course on selling residential real estate in Australia. If you have more information on the course, like the structure or anything else, put that into this box. The more specific you are with these inputs, the better the outputs are going to be from the AI. There's an extensive amount of space in this box, much more than what appears on the screen here. Next, we can upload files, websites, or YouTube videos. The AI will understand and read all the text within the files, the websites, or the subtitles of the YouTube videos. It will train the AI on that as additional knowledge, or alternatively, you can select in step 4 with the outline to convert that specific document into the structure of the course. I'm going to skip that today because it was optional. AI has recommended a potential learner for this course. Try to add information like what the knowledge level of the learner is so that AI can cater to that. And finally, we're selecting the structure or outline of our course. We haven't uploaded any files in step 2, so we can't convert the structure from a file, but we can select the number of lessons, which are like sections, or topics, which are like pages within each lesson. So I'm going to go 3 lessons, 4 topics, 1 quiz, 4 questions per quiz and 1 assignment per lesson. Next, we can choose to change the advanced settings, such as the number of learning objectives, the pass grades. We can set the overview lesson to be switched on, which sets expectations for the learners at the start of the course. Now, AI will generate your course structure or outline broken down into those lessons, topics, quizzes, and assignments. This usually only takes within a minute. It's been very quick here. We can edit all of this content very easily. We can see that these are the lessons that we've got, and these are each broken down into topics, which are their own pages, and then quizzes and assignments. All of this text is editable. We can add new topics, delete certain topics or quizzes and assignments. We can add entire new lessons as well. So once you're happy with the structure of your course, let's save and generate the lessons with AI. AI is now writing every single one of your pages, quizzes, assignments according to that structure. You can see that on the left here. So there's lesson 1, lesson 2, and lesson 3. Now it's written the first page of my course here, and it's also generating an image with AI. And it's done that quite quickly. We can toggle into preview and editing mode to see what the learner we'll see while we're editing the course. You can also click on the read audio button as a learner.
Overview of the Australian real estate market. Welcome to the Australian real estate market. As an aspiring...
This gives the option to the learner to experience the page, listening to AI read it out to them. Back to editing mode, and then the bar at the bottom here for editing purposes appears again. In terms of writing the text and editing the text on the page, We've got a full easy to use editor here, so you can manually make changes, or you can use the AI writer assistant. So just by clicking on that, you can tell AI how you would like to edit or add text to the page. You can also click on the add sources button, which will source links related to the specific content on the page. So it's given me these links related to the topic on my page. If I don't like certain ones, I can exit them, or if I'm happy, we can click add to page. That will add the links to the bottom as further reading for the learner. One of the really cool features that we have is AI video. Essentially, it generates presenter or avatar style videos like this, where a presenter will be on the screen reading out a script that you have given them. We have generated a script for you with AI. So that happens each time where you click on AI video on a page. It will take the text of your page and turn it into a video script. You can edit the text appearing on the video. You can change the logo. And you can also choose your specific avatar that you wish. Additionally, you can change the background color, and when you're ready, just hit the generate video button and that will appear on your course page. I've generated a video with AI now, and it will appear as something like this, where the avatar presenter will say my script out.
Welcome to the Australian real estate market. As a new agent, it's important to know that this market is diverse.
There's a few other interactive options like flip cards, info tabs, and accordions. You can edit the content on each of these. And when the learner goes through, they can click on the card to see the front and the back flip over. With tabs, they can go through each section, clicking on that and seeing the content related to that section underneath. This provides a bit more of an interactive experience for the learner instead of just reading text, especially if you have text broken up into sections and subsections or matching type content. This can be a good way to keep your learners engaged. Accordions is also another option here. We've already generated an image with AI from the start, but if you wish to do it again, the AI image generator is here. You can search our stock image library to add other images, which are photos from our stock image library. And additionally, you can also upload your own images as well. So that will appear here on the page now. The quizzes and assignments have also been written. So we can see the quizzes with questions, incorrect and correct answers in the editor with each question here. If we toggle into preview mode, we can see how the learner will navigate through the quiz experience and be told if they're correct or incorrect. There's also assignments that have been generated here. So if we toggle into preview mode again and just collapse that menu, it's given us a scenario saying you're a real estate agent in Australia. You should provide an overview of this and identify three key players and all these sorts of things. So it's giving us a task based on a real life scenario. It's also generated a grading or marking rubric here where the AI will reference this as the way to grade the student's submission. You can edit all of this, including the scenario assignment, as well as the way that the AI will grade. You can also turn off the rubric and go for a simplified open answer where you provide an actual desired answer. So if you already have an example of what sort of answer you are looking for, you can put that in and the AI will grade the student as correct or incorrect instead of a total percentage. You can set the pass grade. This by default has AI grading and feedback on. You can turn that off if you wish to just manually grade yourself as a human with one of your course administrators. You can also do a hybrid model where moderation is required. This will send the student submissions to the course administrator with the AI generated feedback and grading. It won't show the AI grading to the student yet. The course administrator will have the opportunity to check that over, make any edits, and validate it before it is then sent to the student. As a student, I have answered the question here by putting my text in the box. Alternatively, I can add a document with the text in it. AI will grade the assignment submission as correct or incorrect based on the desired answer. It will then provide feedback on why it is either incorrect or correct. Alternatively, if you have set it up using the rubric grading method, it will outline feedback for each marking criteria, points that they have assigned out of the total amount of points, and will give you feedback on each marking criteria for a total grade. I can also toggle between single and double column by clicking here, and we can drag elements over to the right or the left or below and above. We can also minimize and maximize each element to make that dragging and dropping of the layout a little bit easier. Of course, when we go into preview mode, we'll still see everything expanded. Once you're ready to publish your course, you can click on the Publish Settings button, or you can click on the X in the top right corner. Go ahead and click on the Publish button and then choose Private, Public, or Paid. So paid is the best option if you are selling your course. You'll need to link your Stripe account and then you can set your price. You can see the price has shown up here on the right side. You can also click on certificates to set up a branded certificate and link that to the course so that that will automatically be issued to any learner who completes the course. We can download it as HTML or PDF. We can also edit any content on the course overview page. We can add learners, other course administrators, duplicate the course. We can download it as a SCORM file or integrate through LTI with your LMS. We can embed it as an iframe on your website or web application. Or we can simply share the link with your learners. Another really cool feature that we have at the course level is an AI tutor chatbot. So click on AI tutor. We'll enable that. Now under these settings, we can set up the custom instructions for your tutor. So we've got some defaults saved, but you can edit any of this. You can edit the welcome message. You can give your tutor a name, give it a face, and you can also decide whether you restrict responses or unrestrict them. Basically, this means if learners ask questions that are nothing to do with the course, the chatbot will respond saying things like, "This is out of scope of the course," and they won't try to answer it. You can also train the chatbot on additional content like files, websites, and videos. So I'll go ahead and save that. this takes a little bit of time just to train the chatbot initially, usually about 20 to 30 seconds. There we go. And then if I go into preview mode within the course, great, you can see that tutor is now appearing. So I can open that and start asking it any questions I want about the course. And it will be entirely trained on the course content. This is another way to really make things personalized and interactive in your courses for your learners. And the tutor should respond almost instantly. There we go. So it just makes things quite interactive, and it means that it should reduce the time for you and your course administrators from answering some questions as well.